But that's only like a few percent. I bet there will be 10% max people with 6 character playing on West till tier 3. So basically, if you shit on the minority, it's okay, Aizon. If like, let's say you're talking about IRL right here, right? And then let's say like the minorities right now, basically everyone got shot to death. And you're just gonna say that like, oh yeah, it's only 10% of the population, it's fine. That's what you just said, basically. That's what you said. Basically, like this 10% can't play the way they want to play. But you just say it's okay because it's only 10%. Yeah, it's only the minority. They don't matter. It's basically what like some people said here. So yo, yesterday. Now we come to the real thing. That's the real thing that we want to talk about. Is the alt limitation for, especially for free-to-play player right here. Because this is what is gonna be like, you know. This is what's gonna change the game, basically. Only the open world potion nerf, raid potion still the same. Yeah. Basically, the reason why open world potion is nerf, Germa, is because you can use it on like PvP on the Rowan. So yeah. Potion alcoholic and you should stop charging. Yeah, this is the link of this second page if you wanna translate it to like to English right here. So yeah. So this is the page for the alt limitation. So it's to be implemented on January 12th basically. January 12th, it will be implemented. So yep. Sometime soon. And yeah, these are like the limitation right here. And basically what this says basically is you have like 6 character to earn gold and only those 6 character. That is artist release UE, yes, correct. So yeah, you have 6 character to earn gold. Anything that you have after that does not earn gold anymore. And that's basically the TLDR version of it. And it sucks, to be honest. It sucks. So, I mean, that's basically what it is, right? Basically, if you have 7 character now, you pick 6 character to earn the gold, your 7th character doesn't do anything anymore. And this is per expedition. So, people like me doesn't really get hit because I have like 7 expeditions, right? So I don't really care about this, but basically it is how it is, right? 6 character only. And I have the controversial opinion because like everyone has been talking about this change and saying that like, oh, this is a great change. No, it's not. This is a change that is just, I don't know, I think it's a bad change. So yeah, does it make Void Dungeon as well? Yeah, everything. Germar, if that character earns gold, that locks in as the gold making character. So yeah, the extra character slot from founder pack is useless. Yes, if you have boost over 6 character from free boost or everything, that's kinda useless as well unless you use it on all server. So yep, that's basically how it is right there. So yeah, I have the controversial opinion on this one because a lot of people are happy about this change, right? I'm not. I think this sucks, and I think people that are happy about it are just pretty ignorant about this, to be honest. You won't really be happy anymore in the future. Sooner or later, you will get hit. So yeah, wouldn't they just lower the amount of gold per character instead of limiting number of characters? I mean, that's what their decision is, Elite. They already did. They already nerfed the gold amount, and now they double down on it, basically making sure that like it's dead, like literally dead, you know. So yeah. Per expedition per server? What do you mean level boost? So yeah, so the way to go is I guess multiple account or multiple server, right? Some say that like, oh, it's only for Argos raid and everything. There are some people that say that, right? Nope, nice try, but it's actually everything. So yeah, tier 1, tier 2 raid is there as well. So yeah, and some people say that like, oh, it won't be in NA, right? No, it will be in NA. I mean, of course, that's basically how it's gonna be, you know. Because if NAEU goes through like the same path as Korea, right, then it's gonna get inflation as well. So NA is gonna have that to prevent inflation from the first place. So yeah, people that say it's not gonna hit NA, no, it will, you know, trust me, it will. Unless like, you know, NA is a donkey and just wants to fall to the same hole that Korean just like fall into as well. Then I guess if that is the case, Amazon is a donkey then. So yeah. Hyper Express, etc. Those are account only. So yeah, why doesn't it affect me? Because I have multiple expedition. I play like multiple account and multiple server. So it doesn't really affect me. So yeah, a lot of people also say right, it's a good change for people that have less than 6, right? People that have like less than 6 character and everything, and like they say that like, oh, it's good for me because like I don't even intend to have like more than 6, right? So it's a good change. No, this is not a good change. This change doesn't affect shit to you. It doesn't do anything to you because you're like a casual like 2-3 character anyway to begin with. So it doesn't affect you. It affects like people that have like more than like 6 character. But sooner or later it will affect you, because let me tell you right now, right, there is a female berserker announced. For people that are interested right there, you have to save a slot for it. If you don't, then it's ripped. And how do you know that the next like 1 or 2 years that like you won't have 6 character already? Because you get free boost and new classes, female scouter, you know, artist and everything. Everything that you're interested in, but you're still limited to 6. If you have 6 and then female berserker comes out and you want it, you gotta like circumcise one of your character. Just delete it already, because it will be useless if you boost a berserker over there. So yeah, and that's basically how it is, right? So yeah, people that are like saying that like this change doesn't affect me, so it's a good change, don't care about everyone. It's like saying that like, you know, the analogy that I came up with, you know, you're walking to a bar and then like small gate with a car drunk driving hits your brother next to you, and then you just say that like, oh, it wasn't me that get hit by a car, your brother is dying, you know, and everything, vomiting blood left and right. But I guess, you know, it's not you, right? Who cares? Yeah. Intestines hanging out, but it's not me. So unlucky, bro. So yeah, you should like think about like how it works with everyone, you know, not just for you. But I guess like that's the nature of like people, right? They are like selfish. So yeah, Forgex, thank you for the follow, man. Welcome, dude. So yeah, that's basically it. If my brother is rich and I inherit his fortune, that's what I mean by selfish. Maybe it's good for wealth. That's the thing, Erko. This change only hits people that are honest with like 20 character and everything. Whales couldn't care less. Why would they care? They don't normally run that many character. They just swipe. Right? So why does the people that are like running 20 characters honestly doing the raids, trying to make do with it, right? Trying to catch up to the whales, is the one that get shit on. Why? So yeah. It's also to encourage people to try new tunes. They out a new class and you like it more, so it goes on main lineup, and an old class gets shoveled in reserve. Except it doesn't get shoveled. And what if you like 7 character and you wanna play 7? Well, you can, because well, I mean you can, but the 7th one is kinda useless. As I said, right, if you wanna raise like a 7th character, you can. But raising a 7th character costs gold, and they don't give you any gold. So it's a waste of gold, it's a waste of money. Why? Why would you do that? There is no reason to do that, right? If you wanna raise another character, you raise it on a new account. But then a new account means you have to like work on it again, because it doesn't have skill runes, it doesn't have skill point, it doesn't have anything. So yeah. 6 is a little low, maybe 8 or 10. Well, they decided on 6, so I guess we're cucked right there. So yeah. But yeah, I mean like that's how it is, right? People are people keep saying that they are good with it, the change is good. Nah, they're just ignorant. Because like, you know, just because your playstyle doesn't get affected doesn't mean some people doesn't, you know. I want to play, I want to spend time on the content doing the raids because I like the raids. But I guess I can't do that now, right? I mean, yeah, yours didn't matter because you're a casual player that plays like 30 minutes a day. But what about other players that plays 8 hours and want to raid 24/7? Right? What about those? They get hit and then like you just say you don't care? I don't know, like doesn't sound like a great community right there. But yeah. It is what it is. I mean like, yeah, you can argue that you can just make like, you know, new account, new server and everything, right? Well, thing is like, as I said, making like new account or new server, you get like no skill points, no runes and everything when you have like spend that time getting that on your main. So either way you're cucked. I mean, yeah, you're not cucked like fully, but you're kind of like halfway cucked right there by Smilegate. So yeah, that's basically, I don't know, everything about like the thing, to be honest. They must have something in mind for doing it, maybe something down the road. I doubt it. I highly doubt that. So yeah, something in mind that they are doing it is what's the name? They are trying to like limit gold inflation, gold income. That's what they are doing. And yeah, I mean this will limit it. It just hits like a specific player base. If you're gonna change something, at least you know, make it that it affects everyone, including the whales, including the newer players or something like that. I mean, like, why is it that like, you know, the honest player that plays 20 plus trying to make do with it is the one that gets hit? So yeah. Worries me because I get burned out since the big incentive of making more classes being rewarding isn't there. The game might start feeling stale. I guess we'll see, cast. We'll see. It mostly hit free to play that wasn't once competitive versus those wheels. Kinda, yeah. I mean, it depends, eh? But that's only like a few percent. I bet there will be 10% max people with 6 character playing on West till tier 3. So basically, if you shit on the minority, it's okay, Aizon. If like, let's say you're talking about IRL right here, right? And then let's say like the minorities right now, basically everyone got shot to death, and you're just gonna say that like, oh yeah, it's only 10% of the population, it's fine. That's what you just said, basically. That's what you said. Basically, like this 10% can't play the way they want to play. But you just say it's okay because it's only 10%. Yeah, it's only the minority, they don't matter. It's basically what like some people said here, so yo. I don't know, 6 classes is a lot of gold still. Well, the point is not like about the gold income, DJ. It's about that like, you know, a specific player base that gets like basically the short end of the stick. And then like the rest is okay. Why does the specific player base gets hit? I mean, if you hit the whale, then maybe that's fine, you know? Because whales are whaling anyway. But you hit the honest players that play like multiple character. Why is it like that? It's not about the gold income and everything. I don't care about the gold income. I have like millions of gold anyway. It's not about the gold income. It's about why do you hit this specific player base and leave the other player base alone? Why is it like that? There are other solutions that makes it like, you know, makes more sense, basically. So yeah. Think change is good for overall health of the game? This specific one, I don't think so. Overall, I'm just not happy about this change, basically. I mean, I'm sure like, you know, I'm sure people that have more 6 character will think the same with as me as well. So yeah. Salt Track, man. Thank you for the 5 months, dude. Tasty cake. I mean, the change is made to combat inflation, basically, right? This is like what the change is what made to it. So I'm okay with the changes as long as it hits the game as a whole, because you're supposed to combat inflation as a whole, right? The problem is it only affects a specific player base and not everyone, you know. Casuals are whatever, whales doesn't get hit as well. Hits the middle class, basically, that are like trying to make do with it. So yeah, how would you make change if not this one? I mean, there's a lot of things that you need to fix. Bussing in this game is one of them, you know. Bussing is apparently they want bus meta right now. Smilegate wants bus meta. Because with this change, if it like applies to like the in-game, right? The best way to earn gold is basically to bus. Because character above like 6 character, you don't earn gold, right? You don't earn gold manually. But you do by bussing. Just bus the content. Get like high item level, gear it up, and then bus the content every week. That's how you get gold. And I guess Smilegate wants to do that because they don't fix bussing. And instead they do this. So what since they want me to do that, I'm gonna do that. I will bus 24/7. I will make sure that like Smilegate realize that bussing is a problem. So yeah, normally I hate bussing. I don't like bussing as well. I think bussing shouldn't exist in any game. But if that's what Smilegate wants, I guess I'll just have to do it, right? I don't bus at all. That's why you never catch me bussing on like streaming, because I don't. But I guess you guys will see me soon. So yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, I guess like it's just what the what Smilegate wants. They just design it right there. I mean, this is a problem as well. We in KR have got more than 6 boosts. Just this year alone, we got 6 boosts already. So yeah, so slots of the thing you bought carrying, busing is carry. Busing is carry, yeah. For people that are like more familiar with the term, it's basically carrying. You pay me, I clear the content, you take the reward, basically. So yeah. Yeah, I get a bus driver uniform and everything, I get like the hat, everything, and that's basically busing content incoming. But yeah, we just this year alone, we have 6 boosts already. That means if you started playing this year, right, you're all out of the... all out of the thing already, all out of the slot. No point in doing that anymore. Later artist release, we get a 7 boost, right? Well, you see, it's kinda useless. What's the point of like spending gold over there when it's ripped anyway? Like you don't get gold from it. So I guess so. Yeah, so slots that you bought, slots that you guys will have from Founder Pack in NAEU, right? Characters that you raise after it are basically useless as well. So yeah. Well, not really. You just neutered its main purpose, because if you make more than 6 character, your main goal is 90% is the goal. It's the, your main goal for it, so yeah. So yeah, take into account that like new characters that are unannounced as well, you know, female scouter, male summoner, I don't know, maybe they call it necromancer or something. If you have 6 character already, unlucky, I guess. I guess circumcise one of them. So yeah, you can park your slot on another server. It doesn't mean any. The thing is, leaves, if you make on another server, you still have to regain all of your adventure book, skill points, skill rune, and everything. That just means you're getting cucked still. I mean, not fully, it's just halfway in, but it still hurts, right? They still generate mats though, and there is always playing a new class for fun. Yeah, you play a new class for fun, but you don't just play at level 50, Furia. You have to like invest into the character, gear it up for it to be fun, right? And that costs gold, and they don't return you gold. So what's the point? They still generate mats, true, but so does all of your 6 character. So basically, if you earn 100%, you make a character another one, you do is the same investment, let's say 50,000 gold, but now you earn only 20% instead of the 100%. No one likes it. I don't know if like you guys think it's worth it, but I don't think it's worth doing. So yeah. So yeah, that's basically how it is, right? So yeah, I mean like overall, right, is it pay to win now then? No, I don't think so. It doesn't change anything for whales. But if you're a free-to-play honest player trying to catch up to the whales, you know, playing 20 everything, well, that's gonna be harder, because apparently Smallgate doesn't want you to do it. So yeah. I was down to play supports in NAEU, but this character is definitely not worth the slot. That's a good example. Not worth wasting slot on stuff, yeah. Why cut the 7th character with 80% that is hard? I mean, basically you get cut, your income got cut, but you have the same investment. I mean, if you make it like 7th character cheaper to gear, then yeah, maybe, but it's not. It's not cheaper. So yeah, Smallgate is thinking that for people that has more than 6 character, all those other would be a new source of gold sync. Well, whatever Smallgate is thinking, right, this change basically is like, you know, targets a specific player base and make sure like they die, you know. They just put them right there, put them in the grave, right? Shot a gun to the head, make sure dropped a nuclear to make sure they're like literally dead. That's what they did basically. So yeah, the change does make gold worth more, of course. Yeah, it raises the value of gold for sure at the cost of a specific player base. So yeah. Play it for fun after you grab some gear, it's full max for fun. After that, what you're doing to do with it, that's what sucks about it. I mean, yeah, playing it is fun, but you get no reward of it. And I think the reward of playing your 7th character, right? Your 7th character, you invest on it, and then you do well with it. And then, yeah, it's fun. But how long is it gonna be fun if it gives you nothing? Or if it gives you 80% less reward than your main character? Sounds like a waste to me, right? So yeah, I mean, I love the game, man. I love the game, right? I played a lot of the game. I played more than a year. I spent like, you know, thousands of hours already over here as a free-to-play and everything. And I love Smallgate as well, right? But don't put this game and like this the dev as a on a pedestal and like just praise it for everything that it does right, you know, and ignore whatever it does wrong. Because I think this change is not a good one. I don't think this is on the right direction. But yeah. So yeah. Well, That wraps up the thought of this, actually, to be honest, this alt limitation. Just overall, I don't like it. I think it shouldn't be implemented, but I think it will be implemented, and I guess we'll just have to deal with it. So yeah, I mean, this is how it is. Bring back Akrazio. Yeah, I don't know. I hated this one. I don't know. This change is